Today is July 23rd. Pastor saying to us, the knowledge of the fathers. Our opening scripture comes to the book of 1 John chapter 2, verse 13. I write unto you, fathers, because you have known him that is from the beginning. The Bible says, even so we, when we were children, were in bondage under the elements of the world. Galatians chapter 4, verse 3. This is referring to those who are nepios, Greek, spiritual babies. They are the ones down with the flu today and then headaches and heart trouble tomorrow. But you can come out of that level through knowledge. There's a training that's required. That training brings you into epignosis, Greek, the exact or precise knowledge of God, full knowledge with intimacy. It's called the knowledge of the fathers. In his prayer for the church, the Apostle Paul, by the Spirit, shows us how to get this knowledge of God. He says that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 17. As you meditate on the word, secrets about the kingdom life and how to walk in the reality of the word are unveiled to you. From then on, you know how to live in glory with dominion over circumstances. I would to God more of God's people would come to the realization of who they are and what they have in Christ Jesus. How could you have the very life of God in you and be down with kidney problems, heart trouble, or any other kind of sickness or disease? It's an anomaly. It's not supposed to be. The life in you can't be sullied by infirmities. It's superior to Satan and the elements of this world. Therefore, rather than be agitated when you feel the symptoms of sickness, boldly declare, I have the life of God in me, and that life permeates my whole being and gets rid of all ailments and maladies. Make such declarations again and again, and soon enough, you will literally experience a surge of God's power coursing through your whole being. This is how the fathers respond to circumstances and situations. It's with the word. They are not slaves to the elements of this world. They live above them. Blessed be God. Please say this prayer with me. Dear Father, thank you for your amazing blessings in my life. Thank you for giving me faith in my spirit through the word. Thank you for bringing me into an awareness of truth, to walk in victory, glory, dominion, and honor forever in Jesus' name. Amen. For further study, please read 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 2, 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 18, and Ephesians chapter 4, verses 14 to 15. For the one-year Bible reading plan, please read Acts chapter 28, verses 1 to 16, and Psalms chapters 26 to 29. For the two-year Bible reading plan, please read Luke chapter 10, verses 25 to 37, and Joshua chapters 20 to 21. Rhapsody of reality.